User interfaces for common computer applications are designed with the typical user in mind, but are not optimal for everyone. Currently, people with motor and visual impairments have to use specialized assistive technologies to adapt themselves to software. For example, people with low vision use screen magnifiers, which only allows them to see a fraction of the user interface at a time. Our participants with motor impairments were nearly 2 times slower at using this dialog window, which has been reproduced from a popular application, than able-bodied users. We wanted to reverse this situation. Our system, called SUPPLE, adapts user interfaces to the unique abilities of every computer user. SUPPLE does this by automatically generating user interfaces. Although it considers billions of possible user interfaces, its efficient optimization algorithm allows it to find the best design for a particular screen size, and it takes just a couple of seconds. SUPPLE can generate user interfaces for a variety of different application types. And devices. With our system, people with visual impairments choose the font size they are most comfortable with, and SUPPLE generates interfaces that are easy to see for that user and that also fit the screen. To generate a customized user interface adapted to a person's motor abilities, SUPPLE first collects information about how a person uses a computer. By observing the user perform various basic tasks such as pointing, dragging, clicking, and list selections, SUPPLE builds a model of that person's unique motor abilities. SUPPLE's optimization algorithm then calculates the interface that maximizes that person's speed when using a particular program. How does SUPPLE do in making computers easier to use? Here are some real examples from our user studies. This is an interface you saw earlier, but now SUPPLE has redesigned it to be the easiest to use for a person with cerebral palsy. This user could make fast but inaccurate movements and control the trackball with his chin. Notice that all of the elements in this interface are enlarged to make it easier to click on them with the mouse pointer, and the lists are expanded to reduce the need for scrolling. Now here is the same interface, generated by SUPPLE, but now for a person with muscular dystrophy, who could make slow but accurate movements. Notice that all of the elements in this interface are smaller, more tightly laid out, and they are all presented in a single view, rather than being split across 3 tabs as was the case with the other interface. As these examples illustrate, no single design can address the needs of all users. A design that helps one person will be no good to a person with a different set of abilities. Our research shows that automatically generated user interfaces close the performance gap between people with motor impairments and able-bodied users by 62%. And that the users with motor impairments strongly prefer the automatically generated interfaces to the default interfaces shipped with today's software.